Well, actually, you and I, you know, we could live off the fat of the land for a while. But I want enough. I mean, there's nothing wrong, people, with wanting enough. But the only way that I can guarantee you that you will have enough of whatever it is that you need is if you give yourself to God. That's the only guarantee there is. Because the things of this world can be gone in a moment. In less than a moment. A flood can come and carry away what you thought would last forever. As we turn to our scripture, in John chapter 3, we read these words. After this, Jesus and his disciples went out into the Judean countryside, where he spent some time with them and baptized. Now John also was baptizing at Aenon near Salim, because there was plenty of water and people were constantly coming to be baptized. This was before John obviously was put in prison. And an argument developed between some of John's disciples and a certain Jew, and that person's not named, but a certain Jew over the matter of ceremonial washing, which is baptism. They came to John and said to him, "Rabbi, that man who was with you on the other side of the Jordan, the one you testified about, well, he is baptizing, and everyone is going over to him." Now notice, this wasn't one of John's disciples who was worried about this. This was somebody else. I have a name for this person. They're not named in the scripture, but I think their initials are P.S. You know what that stands for? Pot stirrer. You ever known somebody that ought to be named P.S. Pot stirrer? They're just trying to stir up a fuss, trying to get jealousy to come forth. You know, the church once in a while can get involved in pot stirrer. But what's going on over there with the Baptists? That's how they got more than the Methodists. Or what's going on over there with that preacher or this preacher? John isn't going to play that game. Listen to what he says. To this John replied, "A person can only receive what is given them from heaven. You yourselves can testify that I said I'm not the Christ, but I'm sent ahead of him. The bride belongs to the bridegroom. The friend, what we call best man, the friend who attends the bridegroom waits and listens to the bridegroom, and is full of joy when he hears the bridegroom's voice. That joy is mine, and it is now complete." Can you imagine the best man who starts to cry and fuss and stir up trouble because the bride married the groom? Doesn't make any sense. But that's sometimes what we do. John said, "My joy is now complete. He must become greater. I must become less." That's the heart that God is looking for. Now let's get practical. Williams, how are you? Good. You can hear me? Good. Would you like to see more people in attendance here at Trinity on Sunday morning at 10:30?
Or are you absolutely?
You would. Okay. How is the best way that we can make that happen? Any ideas?
No,
the best way to grow the words of God. To him, God is the Spirit without limit. How many of you want enough? How many of you like enough love, joy, peace, provision, protection, life, hope, peace? He gives that without limit if we give ourselves to him. The Father loves the Son and has placed everything in the Son's hands. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life, but whoever rejects the Son will not experience life, for God's wrath remains on him. So what's going on here? Well, we've got Jesus and John, and they're both teaching and baptizing folks, all right? Jesus' ministry now is really starting to take off. It's in full swing, and his popularity is growing among the people. Now, John is also continuing his ministry, calling people to repentance and pointing them to the kingdom of God. They are not in competition because they work for the same goal, the kingdom of God. They're simply fulfilling their divine destiny. They are simply doing what they are called to do, being who they are called to be. John the Baptist knows, and Jesus does as well, but John the Baptist, a man, a human being like you and I, he knows who he is, okay? do. I think in church, maybe we do that even more than folks' lives, if we pretend to hear about it. It's about us. But it's just a fairy tale. We are not the boss. We need to agree with God that we need changed, reborn. We need to surrender our little kingdom to God's kingdom. When we pray that prayer, my kingdom come, my will be done, my way, I don't think that's how it goes, is it? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, your way, God, right here in my life. Accept God's definition of success. Have we had success today? Has this worship service, which speaks to be over, it's been successful? Some of you say yes. Some of you are saying, well, it will be if it gets over soon. Listen, the door's not locked. You can leave if you have to. I got my knees about 3 minutes, so then we'll see. God's definition of success is faithfulness. Not popularity, not what everybody else thinks. And finally, we need to receive God's blessing of the increase of Jesus in our life by decreasing our need. Oh, this cuts to my heart. Our need to be recognized, our need to be important, our need to be thanked, our need to be honored, our need to, you know, have everybody know. Oh, man. You know what? I got an ego bigger than this sanctuary if I let it out. But it's not about me. And it's not about you. It's not about us. Maggie, who's it about? It's about Jesus. She had that dear little.